Good morning, family and friends, and welcome again to Breakfast of Champions. I'm PY, and I'm here today to talk to you guys about the five stages of relationship. That's right, the five stages of relationship. Listen, the information I'm about to give you guys, I wish I would have had sooner, a lot sooner, and I feel like it would have helped me in many areas of my marriage. But hey, that's one of the reasons why we live and we learn, so that we could give back to those who are coming behind us so they don't have to make the same mistakes that we have made. Listen, I need you guys to understand that much of what I am doing is not from a place of I am successful. No, I want you guys to learn from the failures that I have made so that you don't have to make those same failures yourself. So today I want to talk to you guys about the five stages of relationship. Listen, relationships are a big deal. And after salvation, one of the hardest things that you are ever going to have to do is marriage. And marriage is a big deal. And how your marriage life would be sometimes depends on how your relationship is. So I want to go through the five stages of relationship, what they look like, and what it has become. And hopefully, if you're in a relationship, you can identify some of the things that I'm about to say and look at your relationship and see maybe where things have gone wrong. So there are five stages of relationships. Every relationship has five stages. Number one is attraction. We all love the stage of attraction. The attraction phase is where a man is attracted to the physical things that he sees in a woman, and a woman is attracted also by mainly the physical things that she sees or she hears from a man. Each and every one of us go through these five stages. I don't know anybody who has got with someone and it's not based on attraction. It might not be physical attraction, but there is something about that person that you find attractive. See, attraction doesn't always have to be a physical thing. It could be you like the way the person thinks, you like their personality. But in most cases, the first thing that you see is the physical appearance. So you are drawn naturally to what the person looks like physically, especially us men. We are very moved by what we see. So the first stage of any relationship is attraction. I like you, you like me, so we talk, exchange numbers, slide in the DM, I don't know, Tinder, Hinge, whatever you guys do these days, I don't know. But hey, that is the first stage of relationship. The second stage of relationship is maintenance. So now we've met, we like each other. I like you, you like me, you dress well, you know, I dress well, you drive a nice car, you smell good, whatever it is. We are attracted to each other. There is something that draws us together, yeah, that brings us together, whether it's based on looks, personality, what you hear, what you see, whatever it is, something has brought us together. So now we're dating. Or what many of us go through is that telephone stage where we call each other on the phone and you talk mornings, you talk nights, and all you ever do is you talk, and then you do that whole, no, you hang up. Oh, no, I'm going to hang up. No, you hang up. I know you've been there. That's why you're probably laughing, yeah? We've all done it at one point or another where we first start dating someone. There is that maintenance stage where you just go through seeing how things are. Okay, he's cool. She's all right. You go on dates. You eat here. You go to a show there. You're just maintaining what you have. At that point in time, there's no real arguments. There's no real conflict. There's nothing that the person can do wrong in your book at that point in time. One of the things that I usually say to the people who come to my church is, very rarely will you ever go on a date with someone, and on the first date, when you meet that person, the person sits down, you guys are talking, and the person says to you, shut up, are you mad? Man, you will never ever come across, never say never, you know, but I doubt many people have ever been on a date like that, where on the first date, that person showed you that side of them. See, I understand a lot of people say first impressions count, but when you go on a date with someone, they don't. Because the person is always going to show you the best version of themselves. It's like what we do with Instagram. We only ever post the best versions of ourselves. When is the last time you were on Instagram, and I don't know, maybe one of your favorite influencers or celebrities posted a video of them having a very heated argument with their partner? You'll never really see that. But you can see vacations, relationship goals, all these other things. You always see them on Instagram because people will always show you the best version of who they are. So when you start dating for the first time, you've got the attraction. Now you're on the maintenance phase. On that maintenance phase, nobody can set a foot wrong. But listen, first impressions aren't always right. Sometimes they could be deceptive. You know, all that glitters is not gold. And sometimes you need to dig a bit deeper. You know, when you're looking for gold, you don't just find it on the surface. You've got to dig for it. You've got to get through all the rubbish, all the mud, all the unnecessary things to find that little chunk of gold that you've been looking for. And that's what happens when we start dating a person for the first time. All we see at times is what we want to see, the perception of who this person is in our mind. But the more we begin to dig, the more we begin to get through the mess, we begin to see what we really need in that person. And that doesn't come till you go through the next stage, which is conflict. So after attraction is maintenance. After maintenance is conflict. And this is a very important stage in every relationship, because how you deal with conflict and how you handle conflict will set a precedent for how you deal with it in your marriage. Many people don't know how to handle conflict, especially in relationships. We do this whole toxicity thing where, oh, I'm not talking to you. I'm going to wait for you to apologize. I ain't calling till he calls. I ain't going to say sorry. Whatever it is, however, you know, you don't really know yourself till you date. You don't really know what you're capable of till you're in a relationship. Because the moment you get into a relationship, sides of yourself that you have not dealt with and sides of yourself that you have not treated and looked at or amplified, become amplified by your partner. And when your partner begins to identify those areas in your life that they don't like, at times we get on the defensive side. We become really upset. Oh, how dare you say this, or how dare you say that, you know. But it's no more honeymoon. The honeymoon is over. The honeymoon period is gone. Now we are dealing with conflict. And conflict is healthy in every relationship. I'll say it again. Conflict is healthy in every relationship. The most important part of conflict is common ground. Whether two of you are able to agree or agree to disagree. But that doesn't affect your relationship. If anything, it begins to help you understand the person that you're dealing with a lot better. It begins to help you paint the bigger picture of the person and not just the perception of what you have of the person in your mind. After we look at conflict, the very next stage is a very important stage, healing. Many of us, one of the biggest problems or one of the biggest mistakes, that we make is we get into new relationships without healing from the last relationship. I'm gonna say this one time, heal before you deal. Heal before you deal. The moment you enter a new relationship and you haven't dealt with the baggage of the old relationship, what you do unbeknownst to you is you take that baggage and you dump it on that person. What many of us even do is we have these walls, these big, big walls up. Anytime you have a wall up, you are not really allowing that person to see the true you. And this is why I say at times first impressions are deceptive, because what you may be seeing in that person is a wall, is a front. It's not the real person. The person may be guarded because they don't want you to see their scars, their hurts, their traumas, their vulnerabilities, the things that they've been through, the red flags that they may be waving in their head. They don't want you to see that. And the problem with many relationships today is we haven't dealt with healing. We haven't healed from the past. We haven't healed from maybe what we saw in our parents' marriages. We haven't healed from the divorces. We haven't healed from the separations. We haven't healed, but we just jump into a new relationship expecting that person to be our all and all, our knight in shining armor or our Rihanna or whatever we want to call it to be, and that's not possible. The last stage is a very important stage, intimacy. But I'm not going to get into that today. I want you guys to tune in next week as we look more into the five stages of relationship. I hope you guys were blessed by this real quick morning session. God bless you. Father, I ask, O Lord, that you be with each and every person right now in their relationship. Help them, O God, to know you more. It's really important for us as children of God to get to know you in every relationship before we get to know the person that we're dealing with. Father, speak to your children as we go this week about their relationships, their traumas, their hurts, their pains, their partners. And we ask, oh God, that as you do so, give us clarity in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Friends, family, thank you so much for joining me this morning for Breakfast of Champions. God bless you. Go ahead and drop a bowl because you already know breakfast has been served.